I have two 30-plus-year-old sugar maple trees. For the past 2 years, the top of one tree has no green leaves, and the rest of the tree is turning fall colors prematurely. The other tree is larger and looks normal. Your advice would be greatly appreciated. Thank you, Miss Florence. Right, so we have good pictures here.
They are. Okay. This would take a little bit more of an investigation. I would start at the base of the tree, and I would be looking for, number one, weed eater damage. Number two, girdling roots. You know, when the roots grow around the base of the tree, that's real common for maple trees. I don't know the history of these, so I don't know if they, at one point, they were over-mulched or under-mulched, or it looks like there's a lot of grass under those trees. The second thing I would look for, and maybe four things, the second, with it being a sugar maple, look for squirrel damage up in the canopy. Squirrels love to chew on that sugary bark, that sap. And so look for squirrel damage up in the canopy. Because if they chew around that bark off up there, then naturally it's going to, you know, stop the sap flow going up the tree.
Yeah, I didn't think of that.
Yeah, and then lastly, which this is just an assumption, but it's just one of the things that affects maple trees, and it's verticillium wilt.
All right, so that's what I was going to mention. So we know that definitely affects, you know, a lot of your maple trees.
Yes.
That might be the case.
Might be. I think it's going to be some of the other.
Okay.
Know. I would start with the flare of the tree and look for girdling roots, and then from that point, well, heck, look at all of it. Yeah, to test it for, it may take a certified arborist to test it for the verticillium wilt, or send it to UT.
It definitely will.
But you can, if you happen to get a twig that the squirrel threw out of the tree or whatever, or broke out of the tree, just take a pocket knife and scrape it back into the xylem tissue to see if you see any streaking of the wood in there.
Right. Yeah, that would definitely take a certified arborist to do that and just send it to a lab. Yeah.
Lab is the best way to test for that. You want to, you don't want to misdiagnose something.
That's right. That's exactly right.
Is verticillium wilt treatable? That's a tough one. I can't name off any successful cases of that.
I don't think your maple tree is going to survive the verticillium wilt. I don't think so.
We hope you enjoyed the video. We have hundreds more. To subscribe, just click below.